Okay, so now that we've talked about the basic idea behind the ANOVA, let's just go through a quick example here. We have three different types of feed that were tested on rats over a 30-day period. The data recorder is actually the weight gain for each of the 30 rats in the study. Does the data suggest a difference in weight gain between the three diets? We don't have the units for these, but it doesn't really matter. The units are not really relevant here. Okay, so the null hypothesis here, just like a two-sample t-test, we'd have gone mu1 equals mu2, correct? But now I have three means, so I'm going to say equals mu3. Under the null hypothesis, these are all the same. And the research hypothesis is that we're looking for a difference between them. Now, which one? Well, I don't know, so I'm just going to say at least one is not equal. Somebody's different. And let's just stay with 0.05 for alpha right now. So let's take a look at the assumptions. The first assumption is the idea of independence. Well, these are clearly independent. There's different groups of rats. And there's no connection. This is simply no connection. Between the groups, and that's really sufficient to indicate or suggest the independence. What about normality? Well, for the normality, I'm going to take a look at group one, do a normal plot, group two, do a normal plot, and I'll put group three down here. Group three, and do a normal plot. So let's just jump to TC stats and take a look at some normal plots. So here we are in TC stats. Clearly, this is all ratio data, so I identified each as ratio. Now, notice here that each of these happens to have 10 observations. There's no requirement in ANOVA that they have the same number of observations. It just so happens this data set does. We could easily be 11 or 12 in diet 1, 10 in diet 2, and 8 in diet 3 or something. So let's go ahead and go to graphs and select the normal plot. And let's look at diet one first. That's not bad. There could be some concern up here and in this tail, but overall that's not bad. So for right now, I'm gonna say, yeah, that's okay, that's normal or reasonably normal. And then look at diet two. Again, we have some big gaps here, which catches my eye. That'd be a little bit of a concern. These tails may be extended a bit more than what we expect for normality. But that's not too bad. It's debatable whether you want to call that a gross violation. I don't think it's a gross violation. It looks okay. And then three, we're still seeing these some pretty big gaps here. But overall, that's not really horrible. Okay, so I just quickly and kind of roughly drew these out. And actually, I made this one look worse than it did. But it really is. But it's just a rough a drawing on it. So for here, I'm going to say that these are reasonably normal and then continue on with the ANOVA. So before I complete the actual ANOVA, I need to address the idea of similar variances. Now to do that, I'm going to take a look at the summary statistics for all these guys. And what I'm looking at are the sample standard deviations. I want the big one and the small one. So the biggest is diet 3 and the smallest is diet 2. So that tells me I'm going to use diets 2 and 3, groups 2 and 3, to compare an F-test with. Now think about this. If the F-test says that these are similar, right? If the F-test says these are similar, then this value which is in between is reasonably also similar, so the whole group is similar. That's kind of the logic behind what we're doing here. So for my F-test, now notice the assumptions for the F-test have already been satisfied. The independent groups and the normality. If they weren't satisfied, I wouldn't be here anyway. I'd be doing a non-parametric technique. So my null hypothesis would be that sigma squared of group 2 divided by sigma squared of group 3 is equal to 1. That says they're similar. And the alternative hypothesis would be sigma squared of group 2 over sigma squared group 3 is not equal to 1. Now again, it doesn't matter because I have the inequality, it's a two-tailed test, it does not matter if I did 3 over 2 or 2 over 3, it doesn't matter as long as the null alternative had the same pattern. If I did 2 over 3, I need 2 over 3 here. If I did 3 over 2, I need 3 over 2 here. So now I need to just jump back to TC Stats and simply do an F test. So I'll go to two samples, select an F test, and let's get rid of all this. And I need groups 2 and group 3. And I'm going to select equality and not equal. And tell it to use the variables that I selected. And so I know now it's diet 2 and diet 3. And then update it. And my p-value is 0.3197. Oh, I forgot to put alpha up here, but you know, we like usual, we'll be using 0.5. So this should say fail to reject. Now, remember on the two-sample t-test, when we failed to reject, that meant, and the two-sample t-test, that meant that pool equals yes. That means they were similar. So we should pool. It's the same idea here, only there's not a pool equals yes. We don't actually say that here, but we do say that they're similar. Because we're convinced that the variabilities are similar, now we can go ahead and do the ANOVA. If the variability was not similar, we'd have to make a decision, either apply some type of variance stabilizing transformation, which is discussed in your book, or if we felt like it or decided, we could go ahead and do a non-parametric technique instead. So because they're similar, we're thinking we're okay here. So now I need to just go ahead and complete the ANOVA, make a decision based on the ANOVA, and then state my conclusion. So back in TC Stats, under the analysis area, I take a look at many samples, because there's one sample, and then two samples, and then more than two samples. Maybe this is, say, more than two rather than many, whatever. So many samples, and right there is the one-way ANOVA. And I'm going to deselect all these. And then I'm going to select them all. Select 1, 2, and 3. And right now I'm going to leave Fisher's LSD and the confidence level, leave all that blank. I'll come to that a little bit later. And now I'm simply going to update. Now when I update, so these here are the two variabilities that I talked about earlier that had to do with the whole group versus the variability between the groups and within the groups. And this ratio makes up this value of F for the F statistic. And here's my p-value. So this p-value, 0.0101, clearly we reject and say somebody is different. So my decision would be to reject the null hypothesis. And as a reminder, the null hypothesis was that they were all equal. The alternative, which is seems to be more likely based on the p-value, says, again, that somebody's different. One of these groups is different from the others. So the conclusion is at least one of the groups is different. So in terms of the ANOVA, that would complete the simple one-way ANOVA process. All ANOVA tells you is if one group is different. ANOVA will not tell you which group or groups are different. It would only tell you that there is a difference somewhere in there. So how do we figure out which is different? Well, if I go back to TC Stats and I select graphs and then let's do a box and whisker of all three, I can surmise that diet three is probably going to be different from diet one just based on the way they shift. Diet two might be different from three. I don't know if two and one and two are different from each other or not. It's kind of hard to tell. But my best guess would be that possibly one and two may be similar, but three is probably most certainly different from one. And it may or may not be different from two. And the reason I say most definitely different from one, because ANOVA said somebody's different. And just looking at these, one and three have the farthest differences. I'm looking at the medians right now. Because of the normality assumptions, the mean and the median are essentially the same. So I can look at the median and be thinking mean. So there's really not much doubt that one and three are different. But I just don't know about two and three and one and two, because see, they are shifted. For that, we need what's known as a multiple comparison test. And what we're going to be using here is Fisher's LSD, which is in the next video.